It is great to be with you again.
Ponovno mi je radost da mogu biti sa vama.
I promised you this little story I experienced in the former in South Africa.
I evo obećao sam vam priču o onome što sam doživio u Južnoj Africi.
You know, sometimes you evangelize and things start to get different.
Ponekad počnete evangelizirati i stvari postaju malo drugačije.
Because some people listen to the gospel, accept the gospel, and their life changes.
Neki ljudi slušaju evanđelje, prihvate to evanđelje, život im se promijeni.
And they somehow take you seriously.
I nekako vas počinju ozbiljno uzimati, primati to što govorite.
Yesterday we talked about Acts chapter 1:8.
Jučer smo govorili o Djelima 1:8.
There is a spirit of God coming into the life of people.
Kako Božji duh ulazi u život ljudi.
And then they become martyrs.
I onda postaju mučenici.
They become people who give everything for Jesus.
Postaju ljudi koji sve daju za Isusa.
So something like this happened to me in South Africa.
I nešto tako se dogodilo meni u Južnoj Africi.
In one evangelistic crusades, a general gave his life to Jesus.
Na jednoj takvoj evangelizaciji jedan general predao je život Isusu.
He was a famous general of the South African army.
Bio je poznati general južnoafričke vojske.
And when the apartheid system changed,
i kad se izmijenio sustav u apartheida,
President Mandela called General Scheimolder to become the minister of defense.
Predsjednik Mandela pozvao je generala Scheimoldera da postane ministar obrane.
The big problem which he had to deal with.
Imao je veliki problem s kojim je morao se pozabaviti.
How do you bring the black ANC forces and the white army and create a new one when they have been fighting each other for 30 years?
Kako možete sad dovesti crnačku vojsku s jedne strane i bijelce s druge strane i od njih napraviti zajedničku veliku vojsku, a kad su se 30 godina međusobno borili?
They have killed each other.
Ubijali su jedni druge.
They have killed their families.
Ubijali su si obitelji međusobno.
They've been hating each other.
Mrzili su se.
And now you create a new army out of the two enemies.
I sad od dva neprijatelja trebaš stvoriti zajedničku vojsku.
The South African government did many, many things to unite the two forces.
I južnoafrička vlada poduzela je mnoge stvari da se te dvije sile ujedine.
Nothing functioned.
I ništa nije funkcioniralo.
And the country was at the edge of a war.
I zemlja se našla na rubu rata.
So our brother Scheimolder all of a sudden developed a funny idea.
I naš brat Scheimolder je razvio jednu smiješnu zamisao.
He phoned me.
Nazvao je mene.
And he says, you know what, Johannes?
I rekao mi, čuj, znaš Johannes?
Remember preaching in our church.
Sjećaš se dok si propovjedao u našoj crkvi?
Remember leading me to Jesus.
Sjećaš se dok si me doveo Isusu?
You know, I have a problem.
Znaš, imam sad jedan problem.
The black forces and the white army, they are difficult to unite.
Bijela vojska i crna sila jednostavno ne mogu ih ujediniti.
The black forces, they have been trained by the Soviets.
Crnu silu su trenirali Rusi.
The only white people they have been accepting were Soviets, Russians.
I jedini bijelci koje ti ljudi prihvaćaju su Rusi.
You are Russian.
Ti si Rus.
As the Ministry of Defense invites you to come and evangelize those companies.
I Ministarstvo obrane te poziva da dođeš evangelizirati te trupe.
You will be allowed to go everywhere.
Imaćeš dopuštenje da ideš svukuda.
Please come with another group of Russian people.
Molim te dođi sa još jednom skupinom Rusa.
And evangelize.
I evangeliziraj.
The only thing we can't guarantee you.
Jedina stvar koju ti možemo zajamčiti.
They leave you alive. They leave you alive. They're not killing.
Ostaćeš na životu, neće te upucati.
So I started to look for a team, a music team.
I počeo sam tako okupljati ekipu, glazbenike.
I prayed with my wife about it.
Molio sam sa svojom suprugom.
And we decided to go.
I odlučili smo da ćemo ipak ići.
A team, a music team from Brest in White Russia came with me.
I jedna glazbena skupina iz Bresta, iz Rusije, došla je sa mnom.
For 6 weeks we were traveling the ANC forces.
I 6 tjedana smo tako obilazili te trupe.
I would tell you many, many stories of God's miracles.
I mogao bih vam pričati mnoge priče o Božjim čudesima.
Tell you one of them.
Jednu ću vam ispričati.
We came to this certain place, about 1,000 black soldiers were living there.
I došli smo tako u to jedno mjesto i tamo je bilo 1,000 crnaca vojnika.
When we came to the place,
kad smo došli na mjesto,
a soldier came out and pointing his Kalashnikov into me.
Došao je jedan vojnik i uperio svoj Kalašnikov u mene.
He told me, "You white faces, please disappear."
I rekao nam je, vi bljedoliki, nosite se odavde, nestanite.
We'll kill you.
Upucat ćemo vas sve.
Then I showed him the document of the Ministry of Defense.
Onda sam mu pokazao dokument Ministarstva obrane.
He called his officer.
I on je pozvao svog nadređenog.
And the officer didn't want to allow us to come in.
I njegov nadređeni nije nam htio dati dopuštenje da dođemo unutra.
And then we agreed.
Onda smo se složili.
He would shoot me after my sermon.
Dogovorili smo se da me slobodno upuca nakon propovjedi.
So our program started.
I tako su počeli problemi.
Our group started to sing the first song.
I naša skupina počela je pjevati prvu pjesmu.
But that wasn't a Christian song.
Ali to nije bila kršćanska pjesma.
We were singing Ah, Kalinka, Kalinka, Kalinačka moja.
I to
we
smo
pjevali. That song.
Tu pjesmu smo pjevali.
And all of a sudden the black soldiers started to dance.
I najedanput ovi crni vojnici počeli su plesati.
And move around.
Počeli su se gibati.
Some of them put down their weapons.
Neki su odložili svoje oružje.
Then my group sang a second song.
I onda je moja skupina svirala drugu pjesmu.
And a third.
Pa treću.
And then a Christian song.
I onda jednu kršćansku pjesmu.
And then another one.
I onda još jednu.
And then I was preaching.
I onda sam ja propovjedao.
The officer was pointing his Makarov pistol right into my face.
I ovaj zapovjednik je uperio svoj Makarov pištolj ravno u mene.
He promised he would shoot me after I stopped preaching.
I on je obećao da će me upucati dok završim s propovjedi.
So your sermon tends to become quite long.
I u takvim okolnostima vaša propovjed se obično malo produlji.
You don't know how, when and what.
Ne znate više ni o čemu govorite.
But while I was preaching,
ali dok sam propovjedao,
a very hard message,
vrlo tvrdu poruku,
asking them how many white people they've been killing.
Pitao sam ih otvoreno koliko bijelaca su ubili.
And asking them how many of their relatives were killed by white people.
I pitao sam koliko njihovih rođaka su ubili bijelci.
And then reading to them Ephesians 2, where Jesus united the two into one.
I onda sam čitao iz Efežana 2, gdje je Isus ujedinio dvoje u jedno.
And calling them to come to Jesus.
I pozvao sam ih da dođu k Isusu.
All of a sudden the pistol started to drop.
I najedanput njegov pištolj se počeo spuštati.
In the midst of my sermon,
usred moje propovjedi,
the officer fell down and started to cry tears.
Ovaj zapovjednik se srušio dole i počeo je plakati.
Other soldiers did the same.
I drugi vojnici su plakali.
And all of a sudden, 1,000 soldiers fell down, crying tears.
I najedanput 1,000 vojnika imaš pred sobom koji su pali na koljena i koji plaču.
Some of them ran into us up to the front.
Neki su trčali prema nama, tu prema naprijed.
Asking Jesus to forgive them.
I tražili su Isusa da im oprosti.
I couldn't do anything anymore.
I više ništa nisam mogao napraviti.
You know, whenever the Spirit of God takes over, you stop doing stuff.
I kad god Božji duh preuzme kontrolu, onda vi prestanite sa svojim stvarima.
You asked me why was I able to do so much.
Ti si me pitao zašto sam mogao napraviti tako puno stvari.
Honestly, I didn't do much.
Iskreno, ja nisam napravio puno.
I allowed him to do the
rest. Ja sam dopustio Bogu da radi.
So I went to the front and here was the picture.
I ljudi su počeli dolaziti prema naprijed.
People were laying on the floor.
Ljudi su ležali na podu.
And behind them I saw the weapons.
Iza njih vidio sam oružje.
There were Russian weapons.
Rusko oružje.
American weapons.
Američko oružje.
Swiss weapons.
Švicarsko
oružje. Well, I didn't see any, but I suppose there were some.
Nisam vidio baš ni jedno, ali pretpostavljam da je bilo švicarskog.
People were crying to the Lord.
Ljudi su vapili Gospodu.
And after a certain time of prayer.
I nakon nekog vremena takve molitve,
they got up again.
Ponovno su ustali.
And for the next 6 hours.
I sljedećih 6 sati
my music team was playing songs.
Moj bend je svirao pjesme.
And everybody was dancing.
I svi su plesali.
We celebrated God's miracle.
Proslavljali smo Božje čudo.
6 weeks.
6 tjedana.
Every night an evangelistic crusade.
Svake večeri imao sam negdje evangelizaciju.
Many pistols.
Mnogo pištolja.
Always danger to die.
I uvijek u opasnosti da te neko upuca.
But at the end,
ali na koncu,
there was no war.
Nije izbio rat.
And that country has a new army.
I ta zemlja ima novu vojsku.
We are God's witnesses.
Mi smo Božji svjedoci.
Sent to come in and see the world changed.
Poslani da uđemo u svijet i da promatramo kako se svijet mijenja.
If God is able to do this with a whole nation.
I ako je Bog u stanju to napraviti sa cijelim narodom.
Don't you think he is able to do this with your own family?
Mislite da Bog onda nije sposoban to napraviti sa tvojom obitelji?
Don't you think he is able to do that with your neighborhood?
Misliš da to nije sposoban napraviti u tvom susjedstvu?
The big issue is not is God interested to change your people?
Nije pravo pitanje nije da li je Bog zainteresiran promijeniti ljude oko tebe.
He is.
On to je.
He obviously is.
Očito je da je zainteresiran.
The big question is are you prepared to become his messenger?
Pravo pitanje je da li si ti spreman postati njegov glasnik.
Don't tell me the Croatians are not really able to accept Jesus.
Nemoj mi govoriti, znaš, Hrvati u stvari nisu spremni prihvatiti Isusa.
It is never an issue of them, it's an issue of us.
I nikad se ne radi o njima, uvijek je pitanje da li smo mi spremni.
So what is needed to become a messenger as Jesus was one?
Što je potrebno da čovjek postane glasnik kao što je Isus bio glasnik?
I'd like you to listen to a story out of Acts chapter 3 verse 1 to 11.
Htio bih da poslušate priču iz Djela apostolskih iz 3. poglavlja od 1 do 11.
If you read the Bible,
ako čitate Bibliju,
there are certain passages, I call them window passages.
Postoje određeni odjeljci, ja ih nazivam prozorski odjeljci.
With these stories, a whole chain of events starts.
S ovom pričom, s ovim izvještajem, započinje cijeli niz događaja.
Acts 3, verse 1 and following, tells us how the church in Jerusalem started to evangelize.
Djela 3 od 1 nadalje nam opisuje kako je crkva u Jeruzalemu počela evangelizirati.
How did they copy Jesus?
Kako su oni kopirali Isusov primjer?
How was it with them?
Kako je to funkcioniralo kod njih?
So listen to the story, please.
Poslušajmo priču. Petar i Ivan ulazili u hram na molitvu u 9. sat, upravo kada su ljudi nosili nekog čovjeka hroma od rođenja. Ovoga su svaki dan postavljali pred hramska vrata zvana Krasna, da bi mogao iskati milostinju od posjetilaca hrama. Kako opazi Petra i Ivana, koji su upravo htjeli ući u hram, zamoli ih da mu dadnu milostinju. A Petar zajedno s Ivanom uperi unj pogled pa mu reče, pogledaj u nas. I on ih pomnjivo promatraše u iščekivanju da će od njih nešto dobiti. Tada mu reče Petar, ja nemam ni srebra ni zlata, ali što imam to ti dajem. U ime Isusa Krista Nazarečanina ustani i hodaj. Ujedno ga uhvati za desnu ruku, te ga podigne, a njemu odmah očvrsnu stopala i gležnji, pa skoči, stane i počne hodati. Zatim s njima uđe u hram, hodajući, poskakujući i hvaleći Boga. Tako ga je sav narod vidio kako hoda i hvali Boga. Ljudi prepoznaše da je to onaj koji je radi milostinje sjedio na krasnim vratima hrama, te bijahu preneraženi izvan sebe od čuđenja zbog onoga što mu se dogodilo. Kako ozdravljenik nije ostavljao Petra i Ivana, sav se narod preneražen strča k njima u trijem zvani Salomonov.
And then Peter preaches.
I onda Petar propovijeda.
And after that 5000 men give their life to Jesus.
I nakon toga 5000 ljudi predaje svoj život Isusu.
5000.
5000.
It's a fascinating story.
Fantastična priča.
It is a story which opens doors for evangelism.
To su vrata koja otvara, to je priča koja otvara vrata evangelizaciji.
What is special about the story?
A što je posebno u ovom izvještaju?
See, there is a lame man.
Imamo jednog hromog čovjeka.
He wasn't able to move.
Nije se mogao gibati.
But he was quite clever.
Ali bio je prilično pametan.
There were many lame men in Jerusalem.
U Jeruzalemu je bilo puno hromih ljudi.
Not all of them were sitting at the beautiful door.
Međutim, nisu svi sjedili kod krasnih vrata.
Because the beautiful door was the most prominent place.
Zato jer krasna vrata su bila najistaknutije mjesto.
The person who sat at that beautiful door received most.
Onaj koji je sjedio kod krasnih vrata i prosio, taj je dobio najviše.
You could say it was the most prominent lame in Jerusalem.
Mogli bi reći da je on bio najistaknutiji hromi čovjek u Jeruzalemu.
It was the key lame for some events in Jerusalem.
I on je na neki način bio ključni hromi čovjek u Jeruzalemu.
You could also say he was the mafia boss of the lame in Jerusalem.
On je bio šef hrome mafije u Jeruzalemu.
To get at the spot, you had to have good friends.
I da bi mogao doći na to mjesto, morao si imati dobre prijatelje.
Was still a problematic place.
Još uvijek se radi o problematičnom mjestu.
But people say a lame in such a spot made quite a lot of money.
Ali svejedno piše da je onaj koji je hrom prosio na krasnim vratima mogao fino zaraditi.
In no way he was poor.
Ni na koji način se nije radilo siromahu.
He was a central figure.
On je bio središnji lik.
So this man is now the center of our story.
I sad taj čovjek postaje središte ove priče.
And it's Peter and John who start a chain of events which lead to evangelism.
I Petar i Ivan počinju jedan niz događaja koji vodi do evangelizacije.
And there are four markers.
Imamo četiri oznake ili četiri značajke u ovome.
Which qualify and mark that process of evangelism.
Koje obilježavaju ovaj proces njihove evangelizacije.
First of all, the whole story takes place at the hour of prayer.
Kao prvo, cijela priča se događa u vrijeme molitve.
It is 3 o'clock afternoon.
U 3 popodne.
It is a terrible time.
To je strašno vrijeme.
Because everybody sleeps in Jerusalem.
Zato jer u Jeruzalemu svi spavaju u 3 popodne.
I have been many times in Israel.
Bio sam puno puta u Izraelu.
And I can tell you, 3 o'clock afternoon in Jerusalem, that's hot.
U 3 popodne u Jeruzalemu stvarno moram vam reći, to je najčudnije moguće vrijeme.
And it's siesta time.
I to je vrijeme za spavanje, siesta.
Most of the people sleep.
Većina ljudi spava.
But not Peter and John.
Ali ne i Petar i Ivan.
Peter and John are men of prayer.
Petar i Ivan su ljudi molitve.
They go to pray.
Idu se moliti.
They are young people.
Oni su mladi ljudi.
Well, John has probably been about 17, 18 years of age.
Ivan ima možda 17, 18 godina.
Maybe 19, but not more.
Možda 19, ali sigurno ne više.
Peter was about 26, 27 years old.
Petar je imao 26, 27 godina.
So it's young people.
Mladi ljudi.
They usually didn't go for praying meetings.
Obično prije nisu išli na molitvene skupove.
Like in our Baptist churches.
Ko u našim baptističkim crkvama.
You have a prayer meeting.
Imate molitveni skup.
It's the old who come and pray.
Onda su ovi stari ti koji dolaze na molitvu.
Then you have worship time.
Onda imate vrijeme slavljenja.
A good band.
Dobar band svira.
Then there's the young people coming.
A onda dolaze mladi.
But for prayer.
Al za molitvu.
Well.
A baš.
That's a problem.
To je malo problem.
Peter and John are men of prayer.
Petar i Ivan su ljudi molitve.
For them prayer is central.
Za njih molitva je središnja stvar.
In my country in Germany we have changed our prayer times.
Mi u Njemačkoj smo promijenili vrijeme kad idemo na molitvu.
We have decided that every Friday night we would pray.
Mi smo odlučili da ćemo molitvu održavati svaki petak na večer.
We come together at about 10 o'clock in the evening.
Nađemo se oko 10 na večer.
And then we pray all the way through 7 o'clock in the morning.
I onda se molimo do 7 ujutro.
People who want to pray, they come.
I ljudi koji se hoće moliti, oni dođu.
Sometimes it's just few.
Ponekad je svega nekoliko ljudi.
But I decided I'd rather pray with one.
A ja sam odlučio da ću se rađe moliti samo s jednim.
Than with thousand.
Nego sa tisuću.
Who are not really there.
Koji uopće tu nisu prisutni.
Some people pray like this, you know.
Neki ljudi ovako mole.
They always repeat the same sentences.
Uvijek ponavljaju one iste rečenice.
They may just say, well, Lord, I come to you in this morning hour.
I onda mogu reći, evo, Gospod, dolazim ti ovog jutra.
And then in the evening they say, oh, Lord, I come to you in the evening hour.
A na večer vele, a, znaš, Gospode, evo sad pristupam ti, evo sad na večer.
But the rest of the prayer is the same.
Ali ostatak molitve je isti.
So those praying people are usually asked to stay home.
I od takvih molitelja obično njih tražimo da ostanu doma.
I tell them, you know, you record your prayer.
Ja im velim, čujte, znate, snimite si ovu svoju molitvu.
Give me your cassette.
Dajte mi tu snimku.
And I'm going to play it in the church.
A ja ću je pustiti u crkvi.
We don't need you there.
Ne trebate dolaziti.
Just take home and take your nap.
Ostanite doma i fino drijemajte.
We don't need guys like that.
Ne trebamo takve molitelje.
You want to come and pray?
Ako želiš doći moliti,
it's going to be work.
Onda je to posao.
We'll be in front of the Lord.
Biti pred Gospodom.
In a very, very uncomfortable time.
U vrlo vrijeme koje baš nije pogodno.
So you're invited to come and pray.
I onda pozivaš ljude na molitvu.
Friends, everywhere in the world where people lead people to Jesus.
Bilo gdje u svijetu gdje ljudi dovode druge ljude Isusu.
Prayer is central.
Molitva je središnja stvar.
You go to China today.
Idite danas u Kinu.
You go to Korea today.
Idite u Koreju.
You go to any place of revival in Africa today.
Idite u bilo koje mjesto gdje je počelo probuđenje u Africi.
And I will never have a seminar in Africa in a Muslim country with so few people as here.
Ja nikad ne bih u Africi ili u nekoj muslimanskoj zemlji napravio predavanje, a da bi došlo tako malo ljudi.
There will be maybe 10,000 people.
Došlo bi možda 10,000 ljudi.
Because they pray.
Zato jer oni se mole.
Prayer is a marker of evangelism.
I molitva je značajka evangelizacije.
Wherever a church wants to do evangelism, they have to become a praying church.
Kad god neka crkva se želi uključiti u evangelizaciju, ta crkva mora postati molitvena crkva.
There is no shortcut.
Nema prečica.
You will never, never do it without really involving yourself into prayer.
Nikada, nikada nećete uspjeti ako se ne uključite u potpunosti u molitvu.
Peter and John are men of prayer.
Petar i Ivan su bili ljudi molitve.
And the miracle happens in the midst of an hour of prayer.
I čudo se dogodilo usred tog molitvenog sata.
The second marker which I read out of this story.
Druga stvar koju čitam iz ove priče.
Peter and John come to this lame man.
Petar i Ivan pristupili su, došli su do ovog hromog čovjeka.
And then they look at him and they say, look at us.
I onda su došli do njega i rekli mu, pogledaj u nas.
So what is this?
Što to znači?
Why look at us?
Zašto pogledaj u nas?
What did you see when you was looking at them?
Što je to vidio kad je pogledao u njih?
Well, you saw two Galilean guys.
Vidio je dva Galilejca.
They were not specially dressed.
Nisu bili nekako posebno odjeveni.
I don't think they were too nice.
Ne mislim si da su bili prezgodni.
Maybe John was beautiful, I don't know.
Možda je Ivan baš bio pravi frajer. Ne,
I haven't seen them.
Nisam ga vidio.
But Peter says, look at us.
A Petar mu veli, daj pogledaj ti u nas.
And I see the same pattern with Jesus.
Isto tu stvar vidim kod Isusa.
When the disciples of John came to talk to Jesus.
Kad su učenici Ivana Krstitelja došli k Isusu,
Jesus says, come and look at me.
Onda im je Isus rekao, dođite i pogledajte me.
Look at us.
Pogledaj u nas.
You are allowed to look at us.
Tebi je dopušteno da nas gledaš.
There is no hidden stuff in our life.
U našem životu nema ničega skrivenog.
We are open.
Mi smo otvoreni.
We are transparent.
Transparentno živimo.
I tell you, there was a big Russian with a wonderful saying.
Jedan veliki Rus je izrekao jednu prekrasnu izreku.
His name was Gorbachev.
Njegovo ime je Gorbačov.
He said there will be no perestrojka.
Rekao je neće biti perestrojke.
Without glasnost.
Bez glasnosti.
And you know what glasnost is?
A znate što je glasnost?
Glasnost is transparency.
Glasnost je upravo takvo transparentno življenje.
It's looking through the people.
To je kad možeš vidjeti kroz ljude.
And you know what perestrojka means?
A znate što perestrojka znači?
It's transformation of society.
To je preobrazba društva.
Gorbachev says there will be no perestrojka in Russia without glasnost.
I Gorbačov je rekao u Rusiji neće nastupiti perestrojka dok ne nastupi glasnost.
If you say look at us.
Ako veliš pogledaj u nas.
Then you are open to show your life to the people.
Onda si spreman svoj život pokazati ljudima.
You are hiding nothing.
Ništa ne skrivaš.
There is everything open.
Sve je otvoreno.
In my church we have absolutely no meetings anymore which are closed.
Mi u našoj crkvi više nemamo niti jedan zatvoreni sastanak.
Except of course counseling.
Naravno imamo ovo dušebrižničke sastanke koji su zatvoreni.
There is no meeting of the church.
Niti jedan crkveni sastanak.
Everybody is able to come and see.
Svi mogu doći i gledati.
We do not hide anything anymore.
Ništa više ne skrivamo.
We live in the middle of the world.
Živimo usred svijeta.
Because we want to be light of the world.
Jer želimo biti svjetlo svijetu.
And you never hide light.
A svjetlo nikad ne sakrivate.
Light must be seen.
Svjetlo se mora vidjeti.
You cannot hide light.
Ne možeš sakriti svjetlo.
And then expect that things are going to be lightened.
I onda očekivati da će stvari biti osvjetljene.
It will be terrible dark in the world.
U svijetu će nastati strašna tama.
If you hide your light somewhere in the room.
Ako sakriješ svoje svjetlo u nekoj prostoriji.
Jesus says in Matthew chapter 5,
Isus u Evanđelju po Mateju u 5. poglavlju veli:
Take your light and put it high.
Uzmi svoje svjetlo i stavi ga na visoko mjesto.
And then you see it.
I onda ćeš ga vidjeti.
And everybody sees it.
I onda ga svi vide.
Peter and John were people who decided we are not going to hide any longer.
I Petar i Ivan su bili ljudi koji su odlučili mi se više ne želimo skrivati.
It was dangerous to do what they did.
I bilo je opasno napraviti to što su oni napravili.
It didn't take a couple of days and they were in prison.
Prošlo je svega nekoliko dana dalje i već su završili u zatvoru.
And it will take a couple of years and they will both die.
Nekoliko godina će proći i oba dvojica će biti ubijeni.
They didn't live a life in comfort.
Nisu živjeli nekim lagodnim životom u izobilju.
Peter and John decided to live a transparent life.
Petar i Ivan odlučili su živjeti transparentnim životom.
Evangelism takes place where people pray.
Evangelizacija se događa tamo gdje ljudi mole.
And evangelism takes place where people hide nothing.
I evangelizacija se događa tamo gdje ljudi ništa ne skrivaju.
And live a transparent and open life.
Gdje žive transparentnim i otvorenim životom.
And then Peter brings the third marker.
I onda Petar uvodi treću značajku evangelizacije.
And what does he do?
I što radi?
He tells the lame who expects money, of course.
I onda ovom hromom čovjeku koji od njih sad očekivao nekakve novce.
Silver and gold we do not have.
Mi nemamo ni srebra ni zlata.
What a disappointment.
Kakvo razočaranje.
There's this little joke about the Pope in Rome.
Postoji jedan vic o papi u Rimu.
He washes his hands.
On fino pere ruke.
And then he says to his cardinal.
I onda veli svom kardinalu.
Well, We can't say anymore silver and gold I do not have.
Ne možemo više reći srebra i zlata nemamo.
Because his fingers are full of rings.
Zato jer prsti su mu puni zlatnog prstenja.
Diamonds and gold.
Dijamanata i zlata.
No silver and gold we have.
Mi imamo srebra i zlata.
And the cardinal behind him says,
a kardinal iza njega mu veli,
you're right, Holy Father.
Ti si u pravu, Sveti Oče.
And I'm sorry to say,
ali žao mi je što moram to primijetiti.
We are not able to say anymore, get up and walk.
Ali either. Više isto tako nismo u mogućnosti reći ustani i hodaj.
We have silver and gold.
Imamo srebra i zlata.
But no authority.
Ali nemamo više autoriteta.
We got money.
Imamo novaca.
We have buildings.
Imamo zgrade.
We have cars.
Imamo aute.
We have all this stuff.
Imamo sve ove stvari.
But we are very poor in spirit.
Ali smo duhovno jako siromašni.
If I would have to choose today,
da danas moram birati,
I would not stay and live in the West.
Ne bih ostao živjeti na zapadu.
For me, Germany is like a freezer.
Za mene je Njemačka poput nekakvog zamrzivača.
The churches are cold.
Crkve su hladne.
There is no real life.
Nema pravog života.
I take you along with me to Southeastern Asia.
Htio bih vas odvesti sa sobom u jugoistočnu Aziju.
I would like to take you to the Hmong. To the Hmong in Laos. To the Hmong people.
Hmongima u Laosu bih vas htio odvesti.
I take you to Northern Thailand.
U sjeverni Tajland.
I take you to China, to some provinces.
Ili u Kinu, u neke provincije.
And you will see totally different experiences.
I onda ćete vidjeti jedno čisto drugo iskustvo.
There God is at work.
Tamo Bog djeluje.
They don't have money.
Oni nemaju novaca.
No silver and gold.
Nemaju srebra i zlata.
But God's presence.
Ali Bog je prisutan.
Well, Peter says, silver and gold I do not have.
I Petar mu veli, mi nemamo srebra i zlata.
But what I have, I give you.
Ali ono što imam, to ti dajem.
Peter obviously knows about something he has.
Petar očito zna za nešto što on ima.
He has a gift of healing.
On ima dar iscjeljivanja.
He is able to raise that lame man and put the guy back on his feet.
On je sposoban podići ovog hromog čovjeka i da on ostane stajati na nogama.
Peter has just experienced Pentecost.
Petar je malo prije iskusio pedesetnicu.
The Spirit of God has came upon him.
Božji duh se spustio na njega.
He has power.
Ima silu.
Spiritual power.
Duhovnu silu.
He has authority.
Ima autoritet.
Spiritual authority.
Duhovni autoritet.
He has no money.
Nema novaca.
But he has a gift of the Spirit.
Ali ima dar duha.
See, this is a third marker of evangelism.
To je treća značajka evangelizacije.
Some of us believe we evangelize by spreading trucks.
Mi neki vjerujemo da postoji evangelizacija širenjem traktata.
You know, if you start to measure the thickness of New Testaments and Bibles we have given to the population of Moscow.
Da počnemo mjeriti debljinu papira, novih zavjeta i literature koju smo podijelili stanovništvu Moskve.
Some people say you can pave all Moscow with a thickness of at least 60 centimeters.
Neko je izračunao da bi cijelu Moskvu mogli popločati barem 60 centimetara na debelo.
But they didn't give their life to Jesus.
Ali ti ljudi nisu predali svoje živote Isusu.
It's not because we spread trucks.
Nije zato što mi dijelimo traktate.
It's not because we give everybody a Bible.
Ili zato što ćemo svakome dati Bibliju.
Don't read me wrong, I am for giving away Bibles.
Nemojte me pogrešno shvatiti, ja se zalažem za to da se ljudima dijeli Biblija.
I am thankful for the Gideons doing so.
I zahvalan sam Gideonitima koji to rade.
Don't get me wrong.
Nemojte me pogrešno shvatiti.
But what I'm saying is,
ali ono što želim reći,
evangelism doesn't start here.
Evangelizacija s tim ne počinje.
Peter says, I give you what I have.
Petar veli, ja ti dajem ono što imam.
He knows his spiritual gift.
On zna koji duhovni dar ima.
He knows his calling.
On zna koji je njegov poziv.
He knows what he has to do.
Zna što mora napraviti.
He knows the guy is going to be healed right now.
I on zna da će ovaj čovjek sada biti iscijeljen.
And so he gives the man healing.
I onda mu daje to iscijeljenje.
Friends, it is very important to know what you have.
Dragi moji, jako je važno znati što imate.
Our evangelical churches, they are not able even to count to 22.
Naše evanđeoske crkve nisu sposobne niti nabrojati do 22.
Then in the New Testament we have 22 gifts of the Spirit of God.
U Novom Zavetu navodi se 22 dara Duha Svetoga.
And I would marvel you if you all be able to tell me which they are.
I bio bih u čudu da mi, ako mi neko uspije nabrojati sve njih.
It's very simple to count to 22, right?
Vrlo jednostavno je nabrojati do 22, zar ne?
We all know it, eh?
Svi znamo kako to ide.
Everybody is here is able to name 22 human names.
Svi mi znamo nabrojati 22 imena ljudska.
I'm quite sure you'd be able to name to me 22 produces sold at Dila.
I vjerujem da bi mi mogli nabrojati 22 proizvoda koji se prodaju u trgovini.
We you could do many things in 22.
I mnoge stvari možemo napraviti s brojem 22.
Can you tell me why are you not able to tell me the 22 gifts of the Spirit?
A možete mi objasniti zašto onda niko ne zna 22 dara Duha Svetoga?
How comes?
Kako je to moguće?
This is the very important thing.
Vrlo važna stvar.
See, we know that the members of the body are important.
Mi znamo da su dijelovi tijela vrlo važni.
So everybody knows what a nose is, right?
Svi znaju što je to nos.
You know what an ear is, right?
Znate što je to uho.
You know what an eye is, right?
Znate što je oko, zar ne?
You know what a finger is, right?
Znate što je prst.
What legs are, right?
Što su noge.
I see this little girl, she always does this. It's good. You know it.
Vidim ovu djevojčicu, za sve veli, da, znam što.
Great.
Super.
I like it.
Dopada mi se to.
We all know it.
Svi znamo.
But then I ask you the same question and I will ask you what's the nose in the body of Christ.
I onda ću vam postaviti to isto pitanje, što je to nos u tijelu Isusa Krista.
And I ask you what's the hands of the body of Christ.
Koje su ruke Kristovog tijela?
And what are the ears of the body of Christ?
Koje su uši na Kristovom tijelu?
And what are the eyes in the body of Christ?
Koje su oči na Kristovom tijelu?
And then you say,
A vi samo idete,
Is this also Croatian?
To je i na hrvatskom isto tako,
What's
Što to znači,
What kind of language is this?
Kakav je to jezik?
How comes we say we don't need prophets?
Kako to da velimo ne trebaju nam proroci?
Can you believe you don't need prophets because the prophets are the eyes of the body?
Kako to da velimo ne trebaju nam proroci, a proroci su oči?
You want to be blind?
Želiš biti slijep?
People tell me we don't need evangelists.
Ne trebaju nam evangelisti.
So you don't need any tongue, eh?
Ne treba vam jezik.
You don't want to talk anymore?
Više ne želiš ništa govoriti.
And I could continue like this.
I to mogao bi tako nastaviti.
See, friends, Peter knows what he has.
Petar zna što ima.
And he gives what he has.
I daje ono što ima.
And that's why the miracle takes place.
I zato se čudo i dogodilo.
What I have, I give you.
Što imam, to ti dajem.
And there is a last marker.
I posljednja značajka evangelizacije.
Peter comes to the lame man.
Petar pristupa ovom hromom čovjeku.
And he obviously sins. Commits a sin.
I očito je počinio grijeh.
What does he do?
Što je učinio?
The Bible says he raises that lame man by his hand.
U Bibliji čitamo da je rukom podigao tog hromog čovjeka.
You read Leviticus chapter 22.
Pročitajte se Levitski zakonik 22. poglavlje.
It prohibits to touch a lame body before you go into the temple.
Tamo je zabranjeno dodirnuti hromoga prije nego što uđeš u hram.
There is only one way for you to continue into the temple.
Samo je jedan način kako možeš dalje nastaviti u hram.
having touched an unclean body.
Nakon što si dodirnuo nečistoga.
And the lame was an unclean body.
A takav hromi čovjek bio je nečist.
And that one way is to heal that lame.
Taj jedini način je da tog hromog iscijeliš.
Peter invests everything.
Petar ulaže sve što ima.
He invests his image.
Svoj imidž ulaže tu unutra, svoju reputaciju.
Just imagine, nothing would have happened.
I zamisli da se ništa nije dogodilo.
He would have taken the hand of the lame.
Mogao je toga hromog čovjeka primiti za ruku.
They would not allow him to enter the temple.
Ne bi mu dopustili da uđe u hram.
He would have to go and wash his hands.
Mora je prvo ići pa si oprati ruke.
Everybody would say, see the charismatic, he wants to heal, but nothing happened, eh?
I svi bi rekli, a viš karizmatika, htio ga iscijeliti, a ništa se ne događa.
The modern Benny Hinn.
Suvremeni Benny Hinn.
He believes he's able.
On vjeruje da može.
They'd point with their fingers to him.
I onda s prstom pokazuju na njega.
So he risks his image.
I on riskira cijelu svoju reputaciju.
He risks everything.
Sve stavlja na kocku.
And a healing takes place.
I događa se iscijeljenje.
God allows evangelism where we are ready to commit everything.
Bog dopušta evangelizaciju kad smo mi spremni predati mu sve.
Church, evangelism requires total commitment.
Evangelizacija traži potpuno predanje.
Evangelism requires total commitment.
Evangelizacija zahtijeva potpuno predanje.
To evangelize once a year.
Evangelizirati jedan put na godinu.
To evangelize time after time, one time after the other.
Evangelizirati uzastopce.
That is never going to be blessed by the Lord.
To Bog nikad neće blagosloviti.
Evangelism requires everything.
Evangelizacija zahtijeva sve.
Peter gives everything.
I Petar daje sve.
And he gives the guy his hand.
I daje, pruža ruku tom čovjeku.
Well, he could do what we usually do.
Mogao je napraviti ono što mi obično napravimo.
We don't give the whole hand.
Mi ne damo cijelu ruku.
We just give one finger.
Mi damo samo jedan prst.
We say, hey, you're lame,
eh? Velimo, ha, ti si hrom.
You're the mafia boss, I know you're lame.
Znam ja tebe hromog, ti si šef ove hrome mafije.
You have not been entering the temple lately, right? I know, I see.
Znam ja da ti već jako dugo nisi išao unutra u hram. Znam, vidim ja tebe.
Friends, try to lift a lame man with one finger, with this finger, you never be able to do so.
Probajte podići hromog čovjeka sa jednim prstom, s ovim prstom, s kojim samo pokazujete i vidjet ćete da vam neće uspjeti.
You have to open your hands.
Morate otvoriti ruku.
You have to open your arms.
Morate raširiti ruke.
You have to raise that man by reaching with your full hand to that person.
Moraš posegnuti prema tom čovjeku ispružajući prema njemu cijelu svoju ruku.
God is a God of miracles.
A Bog je Bog čuda.
In evangelism.
U evangelizaciji.
And that's why he blesses Peter and John.
I zato je blagoslovio Petra i Ivana.
We were talking about evangelism of our family and our neighbors.
Govorimo nešto i o evangelizaciji naših prijatelja i obitelji.
Let me ask you a question.
Jedno pitanje.
Do you know where the lame and the needy in your family and in your neighborhood sit?
Znate li di su ti hromi i potrebiti ljudi u vašoj obitelji i u vaše susjedstvo?
Do you know where the needs are in your society and your family?
Znate li koje su potrebe u vašem društvu, u vašoj obitelji?
See, revival in Jerusalem starts at the point where a needy man is discovered.
Probuđenje u Jeruzalemu započelo je kad su otkrili ovog potrebitog.
Do you know who is lame in your society?
Da li vi znate ko je taj hromi u vašem društvu?
So, Peter and John probably exactly knew. The guy sits at the beautiful door.
A Petar i Ivan su vjerojatno znali, a onaj tip tamo sjedi na krasnim vratima.
They could have taken another door.
Mogli su ući na neka druga vrata.
There were different doors.
Bilo je različitih vrata kroz koja se moglo ući u
hram. Why would you go and pass exactly the spot where this lame guy was sitting?
a zašto baš namjerno ideš na to mjesto gdje sjedi ovaj hromi?
Evangelism requires knowledge of your family.
Evangelizacija zahtijeva poznavanje vlastite obitelji.
Evangelism requires knowledge of your neighborhood.
Evangelizacija zahtijeva poznavanje tvog susjedstva.
Evangelism requires strategic analysis.
Evangelizacija zahtijeva jednu stratešku analizu.
Because we then go to lame people and we serve them.
Jer samo tako možemo otići k hromim ljudima i poslužiti.
If you don't know where the lames are sitting, you are not going to help them.
Jer ako niti ne znaš gdje hromi sjede, ne možeš im niti pomoći.
You may be surprised, sometimes it's very simple to discover the lame.
Ponekad ćeš se iznenaditi, jako lako se pronađu ti hromi.
In my country, I very often visit our churches.
I u mojoj zemlji vrlo često posjećuju crkvu.
And lately I started to tell the Baptist churches.
I nedavno sam počeo govoriti baptističkim crkvama.
In the brethren churches.
I bratskim crkvama.
In the evangelical free churches.
I evanđeoskim crkvama.
In the other free churches.
I ostalim slobodnim crkvama.
Pentecostal, for instance.
Pentekostalcima, recimo.
I tell them, well, let's decide for the following.
Ja im velim, idemo se dogovoriti oko sljedećeg.
You go and find out for me what people think about your church.
Idite i probajte saznati što ljudi misle o vašoj crkvi.
And you ask them how many of them know you.
I onda pitajte koliki od tih ljudi vas poznaju.
And if 1% of the population of your town knows your church.
I ako 1% populacije u vašem gradu zna za vašu crkvu.
I just grant you my salary for the next couple of months.
Ja vam dajem svoju plaću na raspolaganje za sljedećih nekoliko mjeseci.
Normally they tell me.
Oni mi obično vele.
Everybody knows our church.
Svi znaju za našu crkvu.
There was one little nice story.
Zgodna jedna priča.
A church sits in that city for about 100 years.
Neka crkva postojala je u tom gradu skoro 100 godina.
Well, not exactly 100. I think it's 90 something.
90 i nešto godina, nije baš bilo 100.
So anyway, the pastor tells me, Johannes, we run in a tent evangelism every year.
Tent.
They put a tent in and they do
evangelism. Znaš, Johannes, mi svake godine postavljamo šator za evangelizaciju u gradu.
We have a number of teaching sessions in our city.
I isto tako održavamo dosta seminare po gradu.
Everybody knows our church.
Svi znaju za našu crkvu.
Our church building, the sanctuary, is right in the center of the city.
I naša crkvena zgrada je baš u samom središtu grada.
If I do a research on what people think about our church, you lost your salary.
I ako počnem istraživati u svom gradu što ljudi znaju o crkvi, izgubit ćeš plaću.
I told them, I'm prepared to lose my salary.
I onda sam mu rekao, ja sam spreman ostati bez plaće.
You do the analysis.
Ti provedi svoju analizu.
So they did the analysis.
I onda su proveli analizu.
He came to me.
I onda mi je došao natrag.
Not even a 0.5% of the 70,000 people knew anything about their church.
Čak niti 0.5% od 70,000 ljudi u tom gradu ne zna ništa o njegovoj crkvi.
And he tells me one story. He says a young fellow is interviewed just across of their church building.
I ispričao mi jednu priču, veli, jednog mladića smo tako smo proveli kod njega anketu, on živi preko puta crkve.
And he asked him, do you know the Baptist church?
I onda su ga pitali, čuj, znaš za baptističku crkvu?
He says, never heard anything about it.
Nemam pojma, nikad čuo za njih.
Never heard anything about it?
Nikad ništa čuo o njima.
Are you foreign?
Ti si stranac tu?
No, he says, I live at the end of the street.
Ne, veli, ja živim tu na kraju ulice.
Are you passing this place often?
Pitamo ga, često prolaziš tu?
He says daily.
Veli, svaki dan.
And you don't know the Baptist church?
I ne znaš gdje je baptistička crkva?
No.
Nemam pojma.
He says, there is it.
Evo tu ti je.
And the guy looks at it and says, well, you're right. I've never seen it.
I onda čovjek je pogledao i veli, pa da, stvarno, u pravu ste, nikad ju nisam vidio.
He was passing that building, but it really didn't bother him.
I on je prolazio pokraj crkvene zgrade, ali to ga uopće nije diralo.
They were passing the tent every year, but it didn't bother them.
I prolaze su kraj evangelizacijskog šatora svake godine, ali niti to ih se nije ticalo.
They had a little advertisements here and there, but nobody bothered.
Imali su male plakate, oglase s kojima su to navještali ljudima, ali to niko nije čitao.
So the pastor asked me, what can we do, Johannes?
I onda me pastor pitao, čuj Johannes, što da poduzmemo?
I told them, you go to the mayor of the city.
I rekao sam, idi gradonačelniku.
And you ask the mayor.
Pita gradonačelnika.
You ask the mayor, where are the needy in your city?
Pita gradonačelnika, di su potrebiti u tvom gradu?
What can we do? How can we serve you?
Što možemo mi učiniti? Gdje možemo služiti?
And the mayor of the city had a good idea.
I gradonačelnik ima dobru zamisao.
He says, twice a week we have a market, an open market at the central place of our city.
I rekao je, dva puta tjedno održavamo, se događa tržnica, otvorena tržnica na glavnom trgu.
And after the market, this place is dirty.
I nakon što tržnica završi, mjesto je zmazano.
So the mayor said, clean the place.
I onda je gradonačelnik rekao, dajte vi to očistite posle.
And they gave the young people who were declared they're being ready to clean the place.
I onda su ovim mladeži iz crkve koji su bili spremni da će čistiti crkvu.
A nice special dress.
Dali su im fino nove odore.
And the young people put at the back of this dress.
I na pozadinu, na leđa od odore su napisali
a little saying,
jednu izreku.
And it said, Jesus creates order.
I napisali su, Isus voli red ili stvara
or
red.
Probably better, Jesus cleans up.
Isus čisti.
And then your Baptist church.
I vaša baptistička crkva.
A week later, everybody in the city knew who the Baptists were.
Tjedan dana kasnije, svi u gradu su znali ko su baptisti.
Everybody knew.
Svi su znali.
It's those guys who clean the marketplace.
To su oni koji čiste na placu tamo.
Where do you meet, guys? You are so nice.
Di se vi sastajete? Pa stvarno ste dobri.
Who are you?
Ko ste vi?
For 90 years the church was preaching.
90 godina crkva je propovjedala.
Talking.
Pričala.
Having every year a tent.
Svake godine postavljali su evangelizacijski šator.
And nobody knew them.
I niko ih nije poznao.
And now they just cleaned a marketplace.
A sad su samo počeli čistiti na tržnici.
And people started to talk about them.
A ljudi su počeli najedanput govoriti o njima.
You see, you discover the needy in the city.
Počnite otkrivati potrebite u vašem gradu.
You discover the lame in your family.
Otkrite tog hromog u vašoj obitelji.
You discover those who need your service and your hand.
Otkrite one kojima je potrebna vaša služba, vaša pomoć, vaša ruka.
And then all of a sudden a process, a chain of evangelistic events starts to roll up.
Najedanput će se početi događati cijeli niz evangelizacijskih događaja.
So engage in service.
Dakle, uključite se u služenje.
Of course, if you engage in service, it's not just like spreading out tracts.
Ako se uključiš u služenje, to nije baš kao dijeljenje traktata.
A tract you give and you gone.
Daš traktat i onda te više nema, odeš dalje.
But if you have to clean a marketplace,
ali ako moraš počistiti tržnicu,
that's a commitment.
Onda je to predanje.
Every week.
Svaki tjedan.
Twice.
Dva put.
It's work.
To je posao.
It is something you really do.
I to je nešto što stvarno moraš raditi.
And you may do it for a whole year and nothing changes.
I možda ćeš to raditi godinu dana i ništa se ne mijenja.
And people will test you.
Ljudi će te iskušavati.
See, evangelism starts with service and service requires endurance.
Evangelizacija započinje služenjem, a služenje zahtjeva izdržljivost.
Even in your own family.
Čak i u tvojoj obitelji.
And then of course service requires wisdom.
Ali isto tako služenje zahtjeva i mudrost.
There were many lame people in Jerusalem.
U Jeruzalemu je bilo jako puno hromih ljudi.
John and Peter could have healed many of them.
I Petar i Ivan mogli su iscijeliti bilo koga od njih.
No, they went to the special one.
Ne, oni su se odlučili za ovog posebnog.
Healing this one.
To što su iscijelili ovoga
would all of a sudden create a movement in Jerusalem.
Na jedan put će stvoriti cijeli pokret u Jeruzalemu.
That was the right man to get healed.
To je pravi čovjek za iscijeliti.
That was the right man to get into.
Pravi čovjek kome je trebalo pristupiti.
He was known.
Njega su poznali.
So for us it's important to do evangelism wisely.
Za nas je jako važno evangelizirati mudro.
Of course Jesus knows where is the wise spot you have to go to.
Isus naravno zna koje je to mudro mjesto od kud moraš započeti.
Jesus knows who is the key person in your family.
Isus zna koja je ključna osoba u tvojoj obitelji.
Jesus knows who is the key person in your neighborhood.
Isus zna koja je ključna osoba u tvom susjedstvu.
Jesus knows who is the key person in your city.
Isus zna koja je ključna osoba u tvom gradu.
And that key person.
I ta ključna osoba.
We go to.
Idemo baš k njoj.
And that key person.
Ta ključna osoba.
We lead to Jesus.
Ćemo, tu ključnu osobu ćemo dovesti
and
k Isusu.
The Lord is going to help you.
A Gospod će vam pomoći u tome.
I tell you, all revival movements.
Svi pokreti probuđenja.
And I've studied revival now for many years.
I već dugo godina proučavam probuđenje.
And I'm professor in one of the largest universities in the world.
I ja sam profesor na jednom od najvećih sveučilišta na svijetu.
If I know anything, I know revivals.
I ako znam bilo što, bilo čemu, znam nešto o probuđenju.
All revivals.
Sva probuđenja.
Triggered the conversion of key people.
Započela su sa obraćenjem ključnih ljudi.
God knows those people.
Bog zna ko su ti ljudi.
And then all of a sudden something takes place.
I onda najedanput se nešto počne događati.
In my own family,
u mojoj obitelji,
God started with a person who had very lots of influence in our family.
Bog je započeo sa osobom koja je imala jako puno utjecaja u mojoj obitelji.
We were quite a big family.
Mi smo bili velika obitelj.
And when we would come together,
i kad bi se okupili zajedno,
it would take about an hour and my uncle Aaron, he would control everything.
Sve bi započelo i moj stric Aaron je svime upravljao.
Everybody would listen to him.
Svi su slušali što on ima za reći.
He was joking around.
On se uvijek šalio.
We liked his jokes.
Volili smo njegove šale.
He would say something nonsense, but we all enjoyed it.
Ispričao je neku glupost, ali svi smo u tome uživali.
My uncle Aaron was a key person in our family.
I stric Aaron je bio ključna osoba u mojoj obitelji.
And so people found a key to my uncle Aaron.
I ljudi su pronašli ključ da dođu do mog strica Aarona.
Today almost all of my relatives are Christians.
Danas su gotovo svi moji rođaci kršćani.
We have a whole number of us in full-time ministry.
Jedan dio nas je u punovremenoj kršćanskoj službi.
Serving the Lord on 5 continents.
Služimo Gospodu na 5 kontinenta.
Why?
Zašto?
There was an uncle Aaron.
Zato jer je postojao stric Aaron.
Who is your uncle Aaron?
A ko je stric Aaron u vašoj obitelji?
In your family.
U tvojoj obitelji.
In your neighborhoods.
U tvom susjedstvu.
In your city.
U tvom gradu.
In your school.
U tvojoj školi.
Who are the key people?
Ko su ključni ljudi?
So you see, we do not just run to the lame people.
Mi nećemo samo trčati k nekom bilo kome hromom.
We go to the right lame people.
Mi idemo k pravom hromom čovjeku.
And if they are healed,
i ako se taj iscijeli,
then a whole set of events starts to roll up.
Cijeli niz događaja počinje se događati.
And then 5,000 people give their life to Jesus.
I onda 5,000 ljudi preda svoj život Isusu.
And that would be a great thing, right?
I to bi bila super stvar, zar ne?
You do it once and your Baptist union is doubled in size.
I napraviš jedan pravi potez i baptistički savez se udvostruči.
It's very simple.
Vrlo jednostavno.
You just have to have one lame man.
Moraš imati samo jednog hromog.
At the right spot.
Na pravom mjestu.
You have to have one Peter and one John.
I trebaš imati samo jednog Petra i jednog Ivana.
Yesterday and the whole number of you raised.
Jučer se ustao jako veliki broj vas.
We prayed for each other.
I molili smo jedni za druge.
We became a community.
Postali smo jedna zajednica.
And you decided we go and we want to be evangelists like Jesus was.
I odlučili ste, rekli ste, ja želim biti evangelizator kakav je bio Isus.
Praying,
koji moli,
dedicated,
predan je u potpunosti,
with the knowledge of your spiritual calling,
kad si potpuno svjestan svog duhovnog položaja i svog duhovnog poziva,
with the readiness to put your hands into the hands of the lame,
kad si spreman svoju ruku pružiti i dohvatiti ruku ovog hromog.
If you do so,
ako to učiniš,
then all of a sudden things start to move.
Onda se najedanput stvari počinju gibati.
You know, such lame guys, they never leave you alone.
Znaš, ovi hromi nikad te neće pustiti na miru.
Like my general Mulder.
Kao i ovaj moj general od prije.
He gave his life to Jesus.
On je predao svoj život Isusu.
And now he found me.
I onda je mene pronašao.
They will always be there, the healed lame.
I taj iscijeljeni hromi će uvijek biti tu.
You want your church see growing?
Želiš vidjeti da crkva raste?
And start to evangelize people.
Počni evangelizirati ljude.
And those evangelized,
ovi koji su evangelizirani,
they will create a whole story about Jesus.
Oni će stvoriti cijelu priču o Isusu.
Why is Peter preaching in the temple?
Zašto Petar propovijeda u hramu?
Because the lame is running around.
Zato jer ovi hromi se tamo motaju.
There is a need to explain the story.
I treba im objasniti priču, što se dogodilo.
And so he does so.
I zato im je to objasnio.
And he explains.
On im je objasnio.
5,000 people gave their life to Jesus.
I 5,000 ljudi predalo je svoje živote Isusu.
Isn't that great?
Nije li to prekrasno?
It's wonderful.
To je predivno.
I want to conclude with a story out of Lithuania.
I htio bih zaključiti sa jednom pričom iz Litve.
I was evangelizing in Lithuania 1991.
1991. Evangelizirao sam u Litvi.
We had a wonderful evangelistic crusade.
Imali smo prekrasnu evangelizaciju.
Thousands of people gave their life to Jesus.
Tisuće ljudi predali su svoj život Isusu.
And after 10 days of every day running crusades, I was very tired.
I nakon 10 dana, iz dana u dan smo evangelizirali, postao sam već jako umoran.
And we decided we would go to a little hotel at the Baltic Sea and rest.
I odlučili smo da ćemo otići u jedan mali hotel na Baltičkom moru da se malo odmorimo.
I had a very nice sleep that night.
I jako sam se lijepo naspavao te noći.
And about 9:30 somebody knocked into my door.
I u 9:30 neko je pokucao mi po vratima.
I opened the door.
Otvorio sam vrata.
In the front of me there was a monk staying.
Preda mnom je stajao jedan
Catholic monk.
Ja, svećenik, monah.
Monah. Ja. Yeah. So barefoot.
Bio je bos.
Stand in front of me.
Stajao je preda mnom.
And he says.
I rekao mi.
Brother.
Brate.
We have just rented the local stadium.
Baš smo sad iznajmili stadion tu
we
u našem
like
mjestu.
You to evangelize today there.
I volili bi da dođeš evangelizirati danas.
I told him, you know, I'm a Baptist.
I onda sam rekao, čuj, znaš, ja sam ti baptista.
We do not evangelize with the Catholics.
Mi ne evangeliziramo s katolicima.
He said, well, understand.
I on je rekao, dobro, razumijem.
But we have prayed so long.
Ali mi smo se tak dugo molili.
Would you please come?
Daj molim te dođi.
One time.
Samo jedan put.
And he continued asking.
I nastavio me moliti.
And you know his face was such a needy face.
I lice mu je odavalo da je tako u potrebi.
So finally I decided we'd go.
I onda sam konačno odlučio da ću ići.
I had a band with me.
Imao sam sa sobom svoj band.
Lots of music instruments.
Puno instrumenata smo imali.
I had a theater group.
Imao sam dramsku skupinu sa sobom.
About 50 young people from Germany.
50 mladih ljudi iz Njemačke.
So we went to the stage and prepared everything to run our evangelistic evening.
I došli smo na pozornicu da pripremimo sve za našu evangelizacijsku večer.
And then everything could start.
I sve je bilo spremno da može početi.
About 5000 people came and filled the stadium.
I došlo oko 5000 ljudi i napunio se stadion.
And then as soon as we wanted to start,
i čim smo htjeli započeti,
a very heavy cloud just was pushed by the window by the wind over the stadium.
I veliki teški oblaci, vjetar ih je dopuhao nad stadion.
And it started to rain.
I počela je padati kiša.
I was angry.
Bio sam prilično ljut.
This Catholic monk, he talked me into that evangelism.
Ovaj svećenik nagovorio me na evangelizaciju.
And now our whole technology would get wet.
I sad se sva naša tehnika mora smočiti.
So I was quite angry.
Bio sam prilično ljut.
But the monk, his name was Gediminas. Gediminas.
Gediminas se zvao svećenik.
He went to the stage.
On je došao na pozornicu.
Into the rain.
Dok je kiša padala.
Barefoot as he was.
Bos, kako je stalno hodao.
He raised his hands like this.
Ovako je podigao ruke.
And he was crying tears.
I plakao je.
For maybe 5 minutes.
Možda 5 minuta.
And all of a sudden the Spirit of God spoke to me.
I onda mi je Božji duh progovorio.
He said to me, Johannes, you are a real chicken.
I onda mi je rekao, čuj Johannes, ti si prava kukavica.
You hide here.
Tu se skrivaš.
This man doesn't know me.
A ovaj čovjek me ne poznaje.
He doesn't know my power.
On ne zna koja je moja moć.
He prays for a miracle and you are hiding here.
On se moli za čudo, a ti se tu skrivaš.
Now you get out.
Sad ti izađi tu van.
And tell the cloud to disappear.
I reci ovim oblacima nek se maknu.
I need to tell you I have never spoken to clouds.
Moram vam reći da nikad nisam se obraćao oblacima.
I studied mathematics and physics.
Ja sam proučavao matematiku i fiziku.
I am quite logic in my thinking.
I prilično sam logičan u svom razmišljanju.
I grew up in a good Baptist church.
I odrastao sam u dobroj baptističkoj crkvi.
We never talked to clouds there.
Mi tamo nikad ne govorimo o oblacima.
And it wasn't my custom at all.
I to uopće nije moj običaj.
But if the Spirit of God gets on you.
Ali kad vas obuzme Božji duh.
There is no way out.
Nema izlaza.
So I went.
I tako sam izašao.
I told the monk, please go and hide.
I rekao sam ovom svećeniku, čuj daj odi, tam se makni.
And then I raised my voice to the clouds.
I onda sam podigao glas prema oblacima.
And I want to say it very, very unheard.
I htio sam to reći gotovo tiho, nečujno, tiho.
But you know what the Spirit of God did?
A znate što je Božji duh učinio?
Somebody switched on the mic.
Neko je uključio mikrofon. Well,
I don't know what happened.
I ne znam što se dogodilo.
An incredibly loud voice came out.
I onda je strašno glasni zvuk izašao.
I yelled at that cloud and said, "You disappear in the name of Jesus."
I onda sam se počeo derati i rekao, "Nestani u Isusovo ime."
And while I was saying this,
i dok sam to govorio,
the cloud was taken apart.
Oblak se rastrgao.
And the sun just fell down on the stadium.
I sunce je obasjalo stadion.
Like a spotlight.
Kao nekakav reflektor.
I was shocked.
Bio sam šokiran.
I expected everything but not something like this. I'm not a charismatic.
Sve sam očekivao, samo ne to. Ja nisam nikakav karizmatik.
I don't know anything about stuff like that.
Nemam pojma o takvim stvarima.
And then I preached the gospel.
I onda smo propovijedali evanđelje.
And we sang songs.
I pjevali pjesme.
And at the end we invited people to give their life to Jesus.
I onda smo na kraju pozvali ljude da predaju svoj život Isusu.
All monks of the local monastery was in the front.
I svi svećenici iz samostana su predali svoj život Isusu.
Hundreds of other people were staying there.
I stotine drugih ljudi su tamo stajali.
Giving their life to Jesus.
Predavali su svoj život Isusu.
Today there is quite a vital church in that little city.
I u tom gradiću danas nalazi se prilično živa crkva.
Words, they need an example.
Vašim riječima potreban je primjer, uzor.
God dealt with nature.
Bog je djelovao na prirodu.
He healed sick.
Iscijelio je hromog, bolesnog.
He casts out clouds.
Otjerao je oblake.
He changes situations.
Promijenio je nečije okolnosti.
And then people will ask questions.
I onda ljudi počinju postavljati pitanja.
They will maybe not right away become Christians.
Možda neće odmah postati kršćani.
But they will ask questions.
Ali će postaviti pitanja.
And then you answer.
Onda vi im dajete odgovor.
Evangelism is preaching in words and deeds.
Evangelizacija je propovijedanje riječima i djelima.
Jesus, he preached like this.
Isus je propovijedao na takav način.
And the people were saying he is not preaching like the Pharisees.
I onda su ljudi to primijetili i rekli, čuj, ovaj ne propovijeda baš kao ovi naši farizeji.
He preached in words and deeds.
On propovijeda djelima i riječima.
And when we do so,
a kad tako radimo,
then God is going to open the window of heaven.
I onda će Bog otvoriti vrata neba.
And people will come.
I ljudi će pristupiti.
The leader of the Anabaptists in the Middle Ages by the name Menno Simons.
Menno Simons, vođa Anabaptista u srednjem vijeku.
He used to say, if your life does not lead people to ask you questions.
Običavao je reći, ako tvoj život ne navodi ljude da postavljaju pitanja,
never preach the gospel to them.
Nemoj im uopće propovijedati evanđelje.
Life and word belongs together.
Život i riječi idu skupa.
May the Lord bless all of you.
Neka Bog blagoslovi sve vas.
I wish I come back to you in one year.
Ja bih volio doći ponovno među vas za godinu dana.
You may never invite me, but maybe.
Možda me nećete baš i pozvati, ali možda i hoćete.
And then I see here many people.
I onda ću vidjeti mnoge ljude tu.
Many more.
Mnogo više ljudi.
And at every spot where we have empty spots now.
I u svakoj ovoj stolici koja je večeras prazna.
People said you have been winning during the year.
Će sjediti ljudi koje ste tijekom ove godine pridobili za Krista.
My students today, they liked my jokes.
Studentima su se danas dopadali vicevi koje sam im pričao.
I close with a joke.
I završit ću s jednim vicom.
They say Billy Graham was one day coming to New York.
Rekli su da je Billy Graham jedan dan išao u New York.
And the church picked him up with a big limo.
I crkva je poslala po njega na aerodrom veliku limuzinu.
You probably saw in the television huge cars.
Vjerojatno ste vidjeli na u američkim filmovima na televiziji te velike automobile.
You call them limo.
Limuzine.
So Billy looked at this car and he says to the driver, I have never driven such a car. May I drive?
I onda je Billy pogledao takav auto, veli, čuj, nikad nisam vozio tak veliki auto, šoferu, veli, pa mogu probati.
And the driver says, well, okay, you drive?
I onda je vozač rekao, pa naravno da možeš.
But you know, evangelists, they can't drive slow.
Ali znate, evangelizatori ne mogu sporo voziti.
So it just took Billy Graham about 20 minutes and a policeman stopped them.
I trebalo je proći jedno 20 minuta i policajac je zaustavio Billy Grahama.
Billy opened the window.
I Billy je spustio prozor.
And the police looked at him, saw Billy Graham.
Policajac ga pogleda, vidi Billy Grahama.
And he was shocked.
Bio je u šoku.
So he phoned his boss.
I onda je nazvao svojega šefa.
And he says, boss, I stopped a VIP, a very important person. What do you do with him?
I rekao šefu, čuj, zaustavio sam nekakvu veliku zvjerku. Što da napravim s njom?
And then the boss says, who is it?
I onda je ga šef pita, pa dobro, koga si to zaustavio?
Is it the mayor of New York?
Je li to gradonačelnik New Yorka?
Oh, no, he says, higher.
Ne, sigurno neko puno veći.
Is it a senator of the American Senate?
Je li to možda senator iz američkog senata?
Oh, no, he says, boss, higher.
Ne, šefe, neko sigurno još veći.
Is this maybe the president himself?
Jesi možda zaustavio predsjednika?
No, he says, boss, higher. I don't know who it is, but I suppose it's Jesus Christ himself, then Billy Graham is his driver.
Ja ne znam, Koga sam zaustavio, sigurno je veći od predsjednika ovoga, možda sam zaustavio samog Isusa jer Billy Graham ga vozi.
I hope.
Nadam se.
You be recognized as a driver of Jesus Christ.
Nadam se da će vas prepoznati kao one koji dovoze Isusa Krista.
May the Lord bless you.
Neka vas Gospod blagoslovi.
Amen.
Amen.